it's hard to explain how a lab works, actually, but you know what I do is all the years is try to recruit people who are curious and care about science and are committed and just, you know, have to know. And you have to put up with a lot of failure, because if you're not, you're probably doing boring stuff and anybody can do. You know, I mean, you need to be out there on the edges where it's going to be more, you know, harder and darker, you know, behind what you're doing. But that's the whole point, I mean, after all. And so, you know, you just have to, though, be ready to spend 10 years on something, you know, making incremental steps along the way. You know, you also have to know when to give up. I wouldn't say never, never give up, you know, until you've got enough to know that, you know, you're not just wasting the rest of your career on beating your head against the wall. But in my lab, I've been lucky at times to have people who, you know, are just full of ideas, and we have ideas, we kick them around, we talk, and everybody I train, and, you know, don't do it in a nasty way, but anytime anybody gives you a hypothesis, you come up with another one that fits the data equally well. I mean, that's your job. You know, somebody at lab meeting says, I think this means that, you know, somebody gives their data, says, okay, what do you mean? What do you conclude? I say, anybody else? Can you give me another conclusion for that? I mean, that's the whole thing, right? I mean, how do you get the right one? And it takes commitment. But in my lab in the Berkeley days, and occasionally, you know, the lab would pull together with some key people that we worked together, we talked all the time, we partied together, we went sailing, we went drinking and listening to music or whatever, you know. It was just work, play until it all, you know, got so mixed up you couldn't tell anymore. Well, it is important, although, I mean, there were times when it seemed that there was no life outside the work because everything involved around. I mean, not completely, you know, but like I say, we had, you know, just little spontaneous groups we built in the lab where people who just enjoyed each other and their ideas so much. But, you know, you do have to get away from it every now and then and clear your head, if nothing else. But it does take, it's a slow process. But, you know, when you find it to a scientist, the real key of the realm is knowing something before anybody else on the planet knows it, you know, and really knowing something, and hopefully something important. And that's a selfish little secret, but, you know, it's hard. I mean, it is hard, particularly, you know, you keep doing something, it's right over the hill, you know, right over the hill. There's no J. Jeff Walker song that says, you know, I got one eye on my lady and one eye on the open road. You know, you're always looking down for the next thing. And I guess the thing is, when you can't see how what you're doing now gets you down that road, then, you know, what's in the way? You know, what can you go anywhere? You know, you can't just keep saying, I'm going to do this next experiment, it'll get me over the hill. You can do that for a while, but then if you can't think of the proper experiment that really not only gets you over the hill, but tells you what path to take when you're over it, then probably, I mean, I know I'm being vague because it's kind of, you can't give you hard things, it's just more of a feeling, you know, I'm doing this, and the data tell you, I mean, it's the, just back to the same thing, you look at the data and see where it's leading.